Hey, y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have a reproductive issue of any kind, such as fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, heavy bleeding, hormonal imbalance, then your liver is sluggish and overworked, and it's time to show it some love. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you some signs and symptoms that you can look for that will show you if you need to detoxify your liver. I will also share with you three tips on what you can do to help detoxify your liver. If you are new here, welcome. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson. I'm a certified holistic health coach and the creator of the 90-day Walk to Fibroid Freedom group coaching program, where I help women shrink fibroids and heal reproductive issues naturally using food as medicine. There is a link down in the description box where you can learn more if you're interested. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. Let's get right into the topic. First of all, I am not a doctor. I am a health coach. And if you are experiencing any of the issues that I'm going to bring up in this video, you may want to check with your healthcare provider. The information I'm sharing in this video is not medical advice. It's for educational purposes only, so you use your own judgment. So I am going to share with you some signs that may point to the fact that you might need to detoxify your liver. As I said before, use your own judgment. The first one is feeling sluggish, tired, and fatigued constantly. Do you have that experience? I know I used to struggle with that. White or yellow-coated tongue, like stick out your tongue, look in the mirror, look at it. Is it white? Is it yellow? Look at it. Check it. Bad breath. Do you have breath, like halitosis breath? There are lots of people who are walking around with bad breath. They're always feeling like they have to put some breath mints in their mouth or some peppermint in their mouth to try to get rid of that funky breath smell. And it could be that your liver is toxic and you need to cleanse your liver. Weight gain, especially in the abdomen region, like a hard belly, like a round belly, but also that could be for other things too, digestive issues. But when you have digestive issues, your liver is tied right into that. Also, unexplained food cravings, like you're trying to eat right and you just can't seem to eat right. Food cravings definitely point to your liver being overworked and detoxified and needing a detoxification. The next one is blood sugar issues. Are your blood sugar issues all over the place? Do you have high blood sugars, low blood sugars, or have you developed insulin resistance? Have you developed pre-diabetic diabetes? Have you developed diabetes? These are all signs that could point to your liver needing to be detoxified. Headaches, unexplained headaches, migraines. Sometimes you might take a medication to get rid of the headache and the headache doesn't go away. Your digestion is poor. Like you eat stuff and it just doesn't feel like it's digesting. You might stay bloated. You might just feel uncomfortable in your stomach. And even you might even poop and food is coming out the way it went in or partially digested. Those are signs that your liver is like, look, I need some help here. And there's other issues that could surround that, but your liver could point to that as well. Feeling nauseous after you eat fatty meals. It's because probably your liver and your gallbladder need a little bit of work. So it's not your body's not metabolizing or digesting the fat that you eat the way it should. Pain on your right side, the right side of your stomach. This can be indicative of other issues as well, but like the area right, like underneath your breast where your rib cage is on your right hand side, that could be a sluggish liver, sluggish gallbladder. And sometimes that pain is really intense. And like if you go to the hospital, a lot of times they'll try to take your gallbladder out because it is congested. And some of you watching this might even have already experienced that. But if you cleanse your liver, you can cleanse your gallbladder. And I'm going to give you some tips on what you can do in just a few minutes. But I used to experience that pain on my right side, and it would feel like somebody was almost stabbing me, but it also felt like pressure at times. And I have all my organs. I have never gotten my gallbladder taken out or anything like that. But I believe the reason that I didn't have to get that done at some point in my life, multiple times, actually, because I would always go to the edge and then come back, go to the edge and come back, is I would cleanse my liver. And so I wouldn't have the issue anymore. Also, skin breakouts. Oh my goodness. There was a time in my life where I had cystic acne all over my cheeks and my chin. I would get rashes. I would have dandruff like crazy. And I believe I was never diagnosed with psoriasis, but the dandruff was so bad in my head that I believe it was actually psoriasis, because it was these big flakes, and they would, like, if I would touch my scalp, it would be like, it was crazy. And at the time that this was happening, I was actually getting relaxers, and I would go to my hairdresser every week to get my hair done and get a wrap, so I would look fresh and everything for work and everything. And my hairstylist was like, I have treated your scalp. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why you're having all this dandruff. And I realized it was because my liver and my gut, but my liver was like overworked, overstimulated, like it was sluggish. And so once I did some cleansing, the psoriasis, dandruff, rashes, acne, all those things went away. Allergy sensitivities, like, are you allergic to everything? Like smells, craziness around you, like that you weren't allergic to before or sensitive to before. That's a sign that your liver's like, okay, my job is to kind of try to filter through all this stuff, but I'm overworked and I cannot do it. So you'll get an allergic reaction. That's kind of how that works. Also, mood swings, hormonal ups and downs, that kind of thing. Liver. The liver, also, if you're angry all the time or bitter or just like always negative, that could be pointing to the fact that you have, you need to cleanse your liver. And the last one I want to talk about is reproductive issues, fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, heavy bleeding, cysts, polyps, anemia, low iron. I mean, whatever you are exhibiting in your body, if you cleanse your liver, these things that you struggle with will become a thing in the past. And it's not just like you do a liver cleanse and everything is good. Your liver is being bombarded by toxins in the environment, and the things that we eat and the things that we drink and the things that we're thinking in our heads on a regular basis. So we kind of have to be always cleansing or always detoxing, not in some deep cleanse. Like, I'm not saying be on a juice fast for your whole life, or that you have to be on a specific detox regimen for your whole life in order to keep your liver cleansed. But what I'm saying is that we do the best we can to avoid the things that cause our bodies to cause our liver to be toxic in the first place. We do the best that we can in our everyday life. That's how we take care of our liver. But there are some things when you are in trouble, that simple things that you can do to help you get the load off of your liver. And today I'm not going to be talking about like some horrible, like, you know, liver detox that you need to do where you need to drink this potion and, you know, and like fast for 3 days. And like, I know all about those liver detoxes, and I'm not saying that they don't work, but like, I'm not into harsh detoxification. I'm into, let's do something every day to help us to take the load off of our bodies. That's what I'm into. So there is not some pill that you can take that's going to, oh, let's detoxify your body. There's not some one, you know, process that you can do that's going to detoxify your liver. Like, there are things you can do like that, but it's like, if you don't change what got your liver in the situation that it's in the first place, there's really not much good you're going to be able to do to your do for your liver. Does that make sense? Like, you could do all this stuff, like these liver cleanses and all this stuff, all you want to, but if you don't change your lifestyle, even a little bit, your liver's still going to be in trouble. You're still going to have all those symptoms. Hopefully you're getting what I'm saying. So the first thing, I'm going to give you three tips. The first thing to do is to get rid of the foods that are causing the problem. So if you haven't already downloaded my Foods to Avoid to Help You Shrink Fibroids Naturally ebook, then download it. Because if you avoid the foods that are on that list, it's automatically going to help take the pressure off of your liver. And it's not just about fibroids. That Foods to Avoid list, I wrote it for fibroids because that was the thing that most people had the most problem with in my audience. So I wrote it for it. But use that list if you have fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, heavy bleeding, cysts, polyps, low iron, whatever it is you have, use it, because what it'll do is take the load off of your body and you will start to cleanse your body and you'll start to feel better. So there's a link down in the description box below, so that you, below this video, where you can download that ebook, and I'll even put it up in the cards. I'm not sure if it's the right or the left side, but you get my drift. But these foods that we eat, like the meat, the dairy, the alcohol, the caffeine, the sugar, the processed foods, the foods that are on that list, they bombard our liver with toxins and turn your, and in turn, your liver cannot function the way it was created to function. So when you stop eating these foods, you give your liver a break and a chance to cleanse and heal from being neglected over the years. So download that Foods to Avoid list as soon as you possibly can. Start to implement the process of not eating those foods. And the list is the same for all reproductive issues and for detoxifying the liver. So get rid of those foods. And you're like, Chelsea, what am I supposed to eat? What am I supposed to eat if I detoxify my, if I take all these foods out? Well, you can look at the recipe playlists on my website, on my YouTube channel. Link to the playlist is down in the description box below. Like, there's a What I Eat in a Day playlist and recipe playlist, so you can look at those. Also, my website recipe section is going to be up soon. I know that I took it down earlier this year, but I was revamping my website and we're still working on getting that together. And I'm hoping to have that by the end of the year done, so you can see recipes that I have up there for free. If not, I have ebooks that you can purchase where you can get meal plans, and you don't even have to use them as meal plans. You can use them as like recipe references, like what do I eat? Go and follow those recipes in there and you will start to feel better. So number two, drink loads of water every single day. This will help your body to flush toxins and help cleanse your liver thoroughly. Make sure you are drinking the cleanest water you can find. My water of choice is distilled water. I don't drink out of plastic bottles. I think it's toxic. I do it in an emergency situation. But when I do carry water with me and I can't use a glass bottle, I'll try to buy the boxed water bottles, which nowadays they're selling them in Whole Foods, Sprouts Farmers Market. And I don't know if there's any other place where they're selling them, maybe Kroger, maybe Harris Teeter. I'm not sure. But those are the places where I buy water. That's the type of water that I try to buy if I'm out and I don't have my distilled water with me. I don't buy distilled water in the plastic containers because it is toxic. I do have a distiller, and I will put a link down in the description box of which distiller I use. It's Mega Home. It's a Mega Home water distiller, and I will put a link up here in the card so you can see that as well. But it is the best water because my body can actually absorb it because it doesn't have all the junk in it that causes my body not to want to receive the water into my cells. So the other thing that I do too is I will structure my water by adding lemons and limes. Limes are my favorite. They seem to do the best with helping my body to absorb the water. And the one thing I want to say is if you are adding lemons or limes to your water, do not, under any circumstances, use lemon or lime in a plastic bottle. I don't care if it's BPA free or not, because what happens is the lemon leaches, because it's astringent, it leaches the plastic out of the bottle. So you're drinking this lemon water thinking you're doing great, but you're also drinking the plastic particles from the water being, from the lemon leaching into the water, the plastic into the water. So it's kind of like you're defeating the purpose of what you're trying to do. So if you're going to put lemon or lime in your water, use either stainless steel or glass. Okay. But that's how I drink my water. But the other way you get water is through eating raw fruits and vegetables as much as you can, because there's plenty of water in that and your body will absorb the water from the fruits and vegetables. Okay. And now next, how much water should I drink? So people always ask me that. I think you need at least 3 liters of water every day. Because, and that doesn't include like your herbal teas and stuff like that, that you drink. Because some herbal teas some herbs have flushing or are flushing herbs. And so it kind of takes the water from your body to actually detoxify your organ or gland that it's working on. So you have to drink extra water. So I say, don't even count the water in your herbal tea. Drink your 3 liters of water, 96 ounces, and that might seem like a lot, but it's not. Our bodies need 2.7 liters of water every day for our organs and glands to function normally. And you're like, how am I supposed to drink that much? Well, build up to it. And when you build up to it and you get into a habit of it, you will start to feel better. You will start to get used to it. And then what you'll start seeing happen is your periods will get better. Your skin will start looking better. Your bowel movements will start to come for those of you who are constipated. Your liver will start working properly. It will start to cleanse. The symptoms that you're having from the fibroid situation or the reproductive issue you're having will start to alleviate. If you want to reverse anemia, you need to be hydrated anyway, because you need hydration in order to make new blood cells. So if you're dehydrated constantly, you're going to feel horrible. You're going to have brain fog. Like, there's so many uses for water. So don't like forget water. Water is important. Our bodies are made up of like 70 or 80% water. I can't remember which one it is right now. And if you drink almost no water, like, what is your body made up of? Like, where's it getting its water? It's why you don't feel good. All right. So here's the third tip. Use herbs that are known to help the liver. I made an herbal blend that will help you to cleanse the liver and help balance your hormones. I will insert a picture here of that. And there will be a link to the tea that I made on my website. You can go to whatchelseaeats.com and click on herbal blends, or you can go to deeprootedherbalblends.com. Either one, What Chelsea Eats is probably the easiest to go and get this liver tea. It's nutrient dense. It is excellent for flooding the body with vitamins and minerals. It's high in minerals. It helps to balance the hormones. And remember, when the liver is congested, it's hard for your hormones to balance. It helps to cleanse and support the liver. It's high in iron. It nourishes the blood. It detoxifies the blood. It strengthens the uterus. It strengthens your digestive tract. It can support like anti-inflammatory, anti-ulcer, anti-cancer lifestyle. This tea is excellent for helping you to cleanse your liver. And all you have to do is drink it every day. If you drink it once in a while, I can't say that it's going to like do miracles, but if you drink it every day, what I do,
this is how I make my herbal tea. Let's pretend there is liver cleanser tea in this jar. So what I take is 3 spoons of each tea that I'm going to use for that day. And I put it in the mason jar, the 4-cup mason jar, the one that is the tallest mason jar. And I put those herbs in that jar and then I pour boiling hot water over those herbs. And I do it at night and I let it steep overnight. And in the morning, I strain the herbs and then I sip on the tea throughout the next day. I cover the jar with a lid and I let it sit on my counter overnight.
I do drink my liver tea every day, but there's other herbs that I drink for my particular body. And I will sip on that tea all day long, drink it at room temperature. And that's how I get it in. But to learn more about the tea that I'm talking about for the liver, there is a link down in the description box. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a heart or a like, I should say, and share it with everyone you know. And one of the things I want to leave you with today is, if no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. And I will talk to you all soon. Take care. Lots of love to you.